20?
Yeah, the gutters.
It was 10 inches or feet, whatever it was wide. You folded it out, same length here, right?
Yes.
So then this has to be 10 minus 2x, right? Did I draw it right? How come I'm looking only at this? I'm not really interested. Really, it's like that, right? But do I really care?
No.
Why not?
Same.
Shouldn't the bottom also be an x though?
No.
No. Well, you can test.
Then that would be.
No, not really. Thinking of that, no, you cannot, okay? I don't really care about how long it is because I want carrying capacity, right? The gutter is used for flowing water, right? So you want this opening to be as big as possible. So you really just want to maximize what? The area, right? The area function, which obviously will depend on how much you bend, right? The x, correct? And also on what will it depend on?
Height.
How much do you bend it, like this, like that? So what? The angle, right? And for me personally, I found it simplest to put the angle there. Do you agree that I can put the theta there?
Yes.
In fact, maybe that's where I should put, well, at first I was trying to put the theta, the whole thing, but I find it simpler to put the theta there, okay? Are you agreeing with me that you really just want to maximize that opening, correct? But that opening consists of what shape?
Trapezoid.
Triangle.
Instead of using a trapezoid, I used a triangle, two triangles and one rectangle.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
So the rectangle is the middle, I need a length and a width, right? I can use 10 minus 2x, correct? But I need to find that. Can I find that if I know, I think it's kind of tilted, right, from your perspective? If this is theta and that is x, can I figure out the height? Yeah, what is it? It's x cos theta, right? Correct? So this is going to be area of the rectangle plus area of the two triangles. Area of the rectangle, and this is kind of how I want you to do it on your test. Guide me, okay? Don't scribble all over the place. So then you're telling me that, and then how much is this? That's length times the height, right, or the width. Everybody clear? So I'm done with the middle, correct?
Yeah.
Now I want the two triangles. But two triangles, the triangle is, the formula is half base times height. Do I have the base?
X sine theta.
The base is this, which is x sine theta, right? You agree?
And why is the x cos theta?
Well, the height is x. Go, it's the same thing, I was going to say.
X sine theta.
It's the same, okay? You need both ingredients. You agree? Okay? So are we in business? Yeah, so therefore, our function is a of x theta. Can we make it nicer? Is 10x cos theta, right? Minus 2. I think I preferred to distribute because I was getting so confused with all my product rule and whatnot. What else can we do?
2.5
will cancel, but actually maybe I can write 2 times. I think I can use a formula for this, right? Right? What is it? If you didn't see that, you don't have to, you just have to mess with product rule. I think I, whoa, there's something here that's a.
Don't do that.
There's an x.
Don't do that. There, right? You see what I mean? Okay, the x belongs to that x, remind me. Do you guys agree? The 2 sine theta cosine theta, you don't have to, but if you want, you can see that that's 1/2 sine 2 theta times what? X squared, right? X squared. Yeah.
So 2 sine theta cosine theta turn into sine 2 theta.
X squared, right?
Yeah, it is. X squared.
That's exactly what I did.
I'm not even sure, I know this was a calculus one problem, so in calculus one, I think you got rid of your theta, right? Somehow, but don't. So now we're doing calculus three, so we need the two variables. What do you think we should do next? We need to get our partial with respect to x, correct? And our partial with respect to theta to get our critical points, right? Okay, what's the partial with respect to x? 10 cosine theta, thank you. Leo, help me, come on, I can't see. Minus 4x cosine theta.
Come on, bro.
Plus x sine 2 theta, is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, and actually at this point, well, let's leave it and go back. And then the other one, we need a theta, right? What is a theta? Partial with respect to theta. Theta is not a variable, so it's negative 10x sine theta plus, right? Correct? 2x squared sine theta, right? And then the 2 will cancel, right? So x squared cosine 2 theta. So far, so good? Is that okay? What do we want to do with these guys? We want to set them equal to 0. Right? Because we want to find the critical points. Is there anything I can do here? And this is where I relented and said, I don't really want to leave it as sine 2 theta. Why do you think I changed my mind at this point about sine 2 theta?
You know,
because I have cosine theta in the first, cosine theta in the second. If I bring this back to what it was, is that good news?
Yeah.
It is, right? If I bring it back to what it was, which was 2 sine theta, cosine theta, what can I forget for now? I can, assuming cos theta is not 0, and it's not, right? Okay. Why do I know that? Do I know that cos theta is not 0 for sure?
Yeah,
because otherwise it will just be standing. See, we're thinking, right? We know cosine theta is not 0 because otherwise then it's just this. You don't have that, right? So I can actually divide across the board by cosine theta. And who will survive here? 2x sine theta. Before I continue, I'm just curious, did anybody do this at home? Did anybody do what I'm doing? Just pretend, right? Are you following the logic so far? And that's how you do that, right? Let's leave that first. See if we can make this nicer. Do you think we can make this look nicer a little bit? I have x's all over the place. Can I just remove one x? Divide by x? Is it okay to divide by x? Yeah, we have to fold the paper, right? Okay. So x is not 0, so we have negative 10 sine theta. Plus 2x sine theta. I'm just trying to make it look nicer. Now these two guys are in terms of sine theta. What do you think we should do with cos 2 theta? Maybe we can write it in terms of the formula, right? What formula was that that only involved sine theta? 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. See, we use trigonometry a lot, right? Okay, let's breathe and think. So what do you do? What do you think I should do? You want to know what I did? Actually, we can... I did my paper, I solved for x. Can I also solve for sine theta instead? I think it doesn't matter, right? You because everybody here is in terms of sine theta, I always like to change my plan, okay? When I did my work, I solved for x, but can't I solve for sine theta here? How much is sine theta? I hope I get the same answer. How much is sine theta?
Five.
Oh, and I see actually I could have simplified this, right? I get 4x minus 10 over 2x, which actually I can simplify to what? 2x minus 5 over x. Is that right? What do you think I can do with that? Why did I do that? So I can plug it in here, right? So then I get an equation involving just the x. And I'm keeping my fingers crossed that I'll get the same answer that I got. Okay, 2x minus 5 over x plus... No.
Yeah,
you're right, right. I'm getting rid of all the sine theta, right? Are you still following what I'm trying to do?
Yeah.
Oh, except I have to square this. I'm not very happy about that.
Can we just have in the original
form? But you guys still follow the logic, right? Yeah, I didn't do it like that in my paper, but I kind of like to mess up with stuff. Can we do the LCD?
This is another easier way.
What I did on my paper was instead... No, I don't think there's an easier way. On my paper, what I did was...
He knows easier way.
What's an easier way?
We don't
use boxes.
Lagrange? What?
No, you just take that derivative of the entire thing.
Don't use top one.
Just make it more complicated.
We have to make it.
Anyway,
you solve this, okay?
That's ridiculous.
So you do that. The other way I did it on my paper was, on my paper, I think what I did was I saw the reduction right away. And then I solved this for x. I mean, so many ways, as long as you can get the answer.
Zero.
You can also do it like that, and then you can substitute it here, and everything will be in terms of sine theta, okay? It's kind of involved, maybe I'll take a picture of my work there, and I got, in the end, yeah, I got the 10 thirds, and I got the theta was 30 degrees, of course the answer in the back is 60, right? Because the 30 really is for what? Well, this is the 30, but you can argue that the answer in the back is this, right? By how much you fold it from the horizontal. Okay?
Can you build the solution on that?
Maybe. You really have to try it.
It's going to be simpler with a triangle, right?
It's a lot of acrobatics, yes, it's what it is. I'm not sure if anybody can think of a simpler way. It's kind of like this.
We know that
5 minus
5
is
the number, and then so we're not
going to be yesterday when I was looking, I got the answer, and I was so happy. So try both ways, okay? It's 8 o'clock. What else do we need to discuss? All right.